with us. Congratulations on all of your Grammy nods.
This
is a full circle moment for you ever since that tweet.
It's so crazy. I mean, that was a dream, you know, me tweeting that. I was probably hanging out with my friends, you know, I was probably going out for pizza, and that's the first thing that popped up in my mind was like, you know, I want to go to the Grammys one day. And the fact that I'm here alongside so many beautiful, talented artists who I look up to, I mean, look around. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. And you're nominated among, you know, your fellow R&B soul acts. You got SZA, you got Gambino. Yes. How do you feel about the genre in 2018?
Killing it. It's going to be killing it. Last year was so amazing. You have Bruno, who's outstanding. You know, you have Childish. 2018, I'm not even ready for 2018 myself, but I know it's going to be awesome.
And you know, you have fans that have fell into your music and they love it and they adore it.
Right.
And a lot of those are, you know, they're kind of curious about like what else R&B has to offer. Mm. So if you had to give fans three albums to study, what would they be?
Channel Orange, one. Ooh, anything by Brandy, two. And honestly, I'm a huge Aaliyah fan. So anything by Aaliyah, she's the GOAT. She will never be recreated. I love her.
That's amazing. And I see that you are rocking the white rose tonight. So what does that mean to you?
It means equality. You know, I feel like this is something that should be talked about everywhere, no matter what the workforce is. And the fact that everybody, not even just myself, the fact that everybody is standing up for something that needs to be talked about, something that needs to change, is awesome.
Do you think you'll ever reflect that in your music?
Oh, of course. I mean, my mom definitely raised me right, you know? So hopefully I get to reflect on that with a song with my mom. We'll see.
So a song with you and your mom?
Oh my goodness. It's not, I didn't make it yet, but now that I said it, I guess I got to do it.